Shalom. Ma shamcha. Ma shlemeh. Boker tov. I am Kahan Tazadaq, master teacher, seer, Yasmin, one sent for the edification of the people with right knowledge in these challenging times. While traveling on my mountain bike in the park, I was actually approached by some Latter-day Saints. That's the Church of Mormon, to those who's unaware. But I didn't get to edify the brothers because I was approached by a black demon that interjected and thought that he knew the word, but he did not realize that he was talking to Yahuwah's man. Yahuwah's man. Kahan Tazadaq. This is that encounter, so take out your pens, your keyboards, computers, and pads, and learn, study, to show thyself approve. And you shall know the truth, and the truth will make you mad, then make you free. Kahan Tazadaq, so you know who said it. Here is the encounter.
Hold on, sir. So you're saying that Adam and Eve...
Here, one person. If just like God, God was no two persons, he was one person. The first creation was made in the image of God. They were one. Over a period of time, with the little story of a reel, God separated. He separated the two. They became two distinct individuals, male and female. But before then, they were one. They were one. Now,
how do you prove that? Because that's an interpretation. So when you're doing antiquity,
well, it says right there in the Bible, he created them male and female.
Sir,
he even said he created a male and a female.
It did say that.
He created Adam, male and female.
No, if you look at...
That's what it says.
Sir, when you deal with linguistics, it doesn't say that. You're reading that English transliteration.
Hey, you got a phone, pull it up.
No, it doesn't say that, sir.
English translation.
So the word that you're saying was male and...
Uh-oh.
The word that you...
All these different translations.
Oh, so you don't want... I can't talk to someone like that. He doesn't want me to talk.
What translation you coming from? I need to know that first.
The Hebrew.
Huh?
The Hebrew.
What?
Hebrew Bible.
So what I'm going to do right here is to prove that the Most High used Adam as a representation of the entire human race, unlike what this guy is saying. So the human race did not represent Eve until she was created. So initially, the Most High had actually only created Adam, as we see here in the book
as
of Bereshit.
As we see here in Bereshit,
Genesis 2 and 7, and making Adam, the man... Ha-Adam, the Most High used the dust of the ground to form his body, and then he breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, the Ruach, and Adam, Ha-Adam, the man, became a living being, Genesis 2 and 7. But in making Eve, the Most High did not go back to the dust. He used one of Adam's ribs to show you that Eve was not there with Adam at that time. He used one of Adam's ribs to form the woman. Ha-Isha, the woman. The woman. When she was brought to Adam, the man said in verse 23, "This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, for she was taken out of the man." Ve'i said Adonai Elohim, Ha-Adam, Ephraim, Ha-Adama, Ve'ipa, Ba'afag, Nishmak, Haim, Be'yehi, Ha-Adam, Le'nefesh, Heya. So we see right here, Adam, the man, became Le'nefesh, Heya, a living being. So the word Adam means man, and Adam and man is literally the same word in the Hebrew. Later on, as we read on, it becomes a proper noun when you read it and get the right noun. So if we go back to the Hebrew text, we see right here that Ha-Adam, Adam, the man, came from Ha-Adama. And so Eve, Hava, did not come from the ground. She came from the man, from his rib. She became known as Isha. I'm giving you this right knowledge because the guy at the beginning of the video, I've heard that ideology before, that Adam and Eve was one in the beginning. That's totally incorrect because Hava, Eve, came later from Adam's rib. Adam came from Ha'adama, the ground. Ha'adam, meaning the man, came from Ha'adama. Do you understand? Do you understand? To get the right knowledge on this, we're going to take it back to the pictorial and the paleo Ibrit, as we see on the screen. The ox head represented Aleph. Aleph is the head, it's the authority. It represents the Most High, Hashem. And so Adam was also made in the image and likeness of the Most High, which means Adam represents a God in absence of the Most High on earth. Woman is not Adam's equal. She's his helpmeet. She was made for him. Genesis 2 and 18. Bereshit 2 and 18. Next we have the dialect, which represents a door, a path. A path to what? A path to eternal life. You go through Adam. So salvation now comes through HaMashiach. But woman is still subservient and under Adam, her teacher. She rebelled against that rulership. And Adam follows the Most High through HaMashiach, Yahusha, right? And then finally we have Mem, which represents waters. You can have chaotic waters. Water could bring about destruction, but it also represents the fleshly waters of life, which is blood. Which is why the high priest will go into the altar once a year and offer a blood sacrifice. I pray that you can receive this, that man is God in the absence of the Most High on earth. He's the Most High's vicegerent. Man is a God. Tehillim 82 verse 6, Psalms 82 and 6. I pray that you can receive it. So the right knowledge on this is that Hashem used Adam's rib to form Eve. He used existing tissue, and he did not start from scratch. And why did he do that? To show that Adam and Eve was actually made of the same substance. She was made from the same stuff and was a barrier of the likeness of man, who was made in the image and likeness of the Most High. Just as Adam, when we read Bereshit, Genesis 1 and 27, the woman was made of Adam's rib and was designed as a companion and a helper that was suitable for Adam. When we read the book of Bereshit, Genesis 2 and 18, Eve formed a physical part of Adam. It was supposed to complement him. She rebelled and hearken to the voice of Satan. Now, why did the Most High use Adam's rib? What's interesting is that ribs have amazing regenerative powers. What do you mean by that, Khan Tazadaq? Portions of the rib bones and cartilage remove in the bone, they graft surgery, will regrow as long as the rib's perichondrium is left intact. So this means that Adam's loss of a rib was only a temporary thing. He did actually not have to go through the rest of his life with an incomplete skeletal system, if you could understand. So when the Most High Hashem bore Eve to Adam, they were united in marriage. The woman, Isha, in the book of Bereshit, Genesis 2 and 22, is called Adam's wife in verse 24, Isha. So the pattern for marriage, the first marriage, the first social institution was established right there in Eden. There was no preacher. There was no peace. Justice of the peace. There was no priest or anyone. It was the Most High, Adam and his wife. So the manner of Eve's creation is why man leaves his father and his mother and is united with his wife. Why? Because they became one flesh. The unity of a married couple and the one flesh principle is actually based on the fact that the Most High, Hashem, used one of Adam's ribs to make the woman. And through, even though Eve committed the sin, Adam was held responsible because he fell as a leader. He listened to the woman that the Most High had actually created for him. And so because Adam simped out, he became like a simp, as many men are today, we fell. But the Most High held Adam responsible. 1 Corinthians 15:12. Let's go to 15 and 21. 1 Corinthians 15:21. For since death came through one man, the resurrection of the dead also comes through a man. For as in Adam all die, so in Hamashiach, Yahusha, all will be made alive. So it's telling us that even though that Eve committed the sin, Adam was held responsible for it because he felt as a leader. See, everyone dies because we all came through Adam. Just as everyone dies because we all belong to Adam, everyone who belongs to Hamashiach, Yahusha, will be given new life. 1 Corinthians 15, verse 22. Now, even though Eve committed the first sin and Adam simped out and followed, we are all counted sinners because of Adam's sin, which was actually credited to him and really placed upon each of us, which is why each of us die because of Adam's failure in his headship role that the Most High Hashem had given him in the Garden of Eden. Or should I say the Garden in Eden. The Garden in Eden. So the leadership role was never given to Eve. It was never given to Hava. It was given to Adam. Now, someone said that everything rises and falls on a leader, which is true. So reflect on the book of Romans 12, for Selakim, Romans 5 and 12. Therefore, just as sin entered the world through one man, and death through the sin, and in this way, death comes to all people because all sin. To be sure, sin was in the world, the law was given, but sin is not charged against anyone's account where there is no law. Nevertheless, death ranged from the time of Adam to the time of Moshe, even over those who did not sin by breaking the commandments, as did Adam, who is a pattern of the one to come. That's talking about the second Adam coming, Hamashiach. But the gift is not like the trespass. For if many died by the trespass of one man, how much more did Yahuwah's grace and gift that came by the grace of one man, Hamashiach, Yahusha, Yahushai, overflow to the many? Nor can the gift of Yahuwah be compared with the result of one man's sin. The judgment followed one sin and brought the condemnation, but the gift followed many trespasses and brought justification. For if by the trespass of one man death reigns through that one man, how much more will those who receive Yahuwah's abundant provisions of grace and of the gift of righteousness range in life through the one man, Hamashiach, Yahusha, Yahushai. Consequently, just as one trespass resulted in the condemnation for all people, so also one righteous act resulted in the justification and life for all people. For just as through the disobedience of one man, the many were made sinners, so also the obedience of one man, the many will be made righteous. The laws was brought in so that the trespass might increase, but where sin is increased, grace is increased all the more. So that just as sin reigns in death, so also grace might reign through the righteousness to bring eternal life through Hamashiach Yahusha. Hallelujah. And that's the right knowledge on this. I'm Kahan Tazadaq. like, share, subscribe. Edification. Have you not been edified? Through the woman came the beginning of sin, and through her we all die. For it was not Adam that was deceived, but the woman. But you failed as leaders. Check this out.
Outside, oh, she cute. She got 3 jobs. Oh my God, she's great for you. I'm not, ma'am. I know some thoughts don't be employed, but I'm just employed thought. On my breaks or whenever I can get free, I'm probably around here thotting. So please don't do it. I can't wait to get a hold of your grandson or son and have some babies with them. Put hella goddamn cell phones in the baby's name, because Lord knows I can't put them in mine. I got bad credit. I got student loans. I ain't got nothing to offer but a pack of ramen noodles and some good cat. That's all I got to offer. And hell, I can't wait to get a hold of your grandson and put some insurance on his ass, because you know them damn noodles that I be cooking, they high in sodium. They all that salt in them damn noodles, he ain't gonna live long. So you know I got to put some insurance on them. I can't wait to get these babies and damn file them on my taxes so I could be balling and stuff. You know what I'm saying? That's all I'm looking forward to. I don't get tired. I'm just like Kevin Gates. I don't get tired. And like I said before, I ain't got nothing but some good cat, so I don't get dry. I don't get dry. Spritz brought on deck down there. That's all I got for him. I could wet the lawn up and grow some grass. That's all I could do. I have his mind gone. I have his ass walking backwards in the rain all day. Please, people. I'm trying to help y'all. I'm trying.